So in the past year, I've been able to grow my very first real business from $0 to $8,000 per month. Obviously, some months are a little bit higher, some months are a little bit lower, but that's just part of the market in any industry that you will be in. But in today's video, I'm pretty much gonna walk you guys through 4 points, pretty much talking about how I exactly grew that business from $0 to $8,000 per month approximately. With these 4 points, it took me a little while to kind of figure out what 4 things you guys can kind of take out of this video and apply to your own business. But I sat down, wrote them down on my computer, and I'm gonna walk you guys through them here in a second. So I hope you guys stick around for the entire video. If you do enjoy it, I'd appreciate a thumbs up. And if you're not part of the family yet, hit that subscription button down below. We're trying to get to 4K subscribers. Enough of me talking, let's get right into it. So I told you guys we're gonna hop into my computer, how I grew my first business to $8,000 per month. I wanna make it known that I had literally tried I tried a lot of things before this. This isn't one thing where I just got into it. It was the first thing I ever tried and I was successful at it, quote unquote successful. I'm gonna kinda define what that means for me, but I had tried affiliate marketing, I tried drop shipping, the whole e-com thing. I had tried probably 3 or 4 other things, and pretty much every single one of them failed. Guaranteed, like, side note though, I probably could have been more successful at them, but I really just didn't have a passion for them after I was losing money. To find a real passion, I recognize that if it is a passion and you lose money, it'll never discourage you. You'll see it as an opportunity to learn and grow. So just note that whatever business you're in, if you're losing money and you kind of get down on yourself and you really don't want to do anything about it, it's probably not for you in the long run. So just take that as a side note. But getting right into it, number one, I made every single mistake in the book, and I think that's super important and also super cringy, so I'm not gonna make this that cringy for you guys, but I pretty much, it's cool about my industry is there's only a handful of mistakes that I can make, which is also kind of identical to most industries that you're trying to get into, especially the ones where you're trying to do online things like affiliate marketing, e-com. Granted, there's probably a lot more mistakes, but for me, that's just buying and selling electronics, mainly iPhones. So for me, from probably day one to 6 months later, I made every single mistake in the book. I never took a course, but kind of in a quote, look at me now, like I never had that kind of thing where I took a course, was successful, gave all my granted success to anybody else. I just kind of wanted to put myself out there. I felt like I really didn't need to. Obviously, I would have probably gotten to this point a lot quicker if I did take a course. But I was a college student, didn't have much money, and just had money I'd made from an internship the past summer. And I didn't have the entrepreneur mind, so I didn't know that it wasn't just spending money, you were investing yourself, and I do regret that, but I can't think like that, and so I made every single mistake in the book. And I was talking about this earlier in the video, if you lose money in something, whatever it may be, whatever industry it may be, and you kind of get down on yourself and you really don't do anything about it, that just shows you don't have a passion for it. For me, the first time I lost money on a single phone, and phones could be pretty expensive, right? I was like, damn it, like that sucks, but how can I turn around? Like, I was so caught up in the idea of how can I avoid these? And so over time, I've been able to figure out many different ways to avoid every single scam out there in this industry, to a point where now I'm able to automate the process a lot. And I don't really have to worry about scams because I know what to look out for, and like the people that try to scam me, I just don't take it anymore. So that's a big thing I want to talk about in how I grew my business to $0 to $8,000 per month. But kind of leading me into my second, I shared my journey doing it, and this is something I recommend a lot of you do if you haven't started already. And a lot of people have come to me on YouTube saying, like, you've inspired me to start my own YouTube channel. That's what I love to see, a lot more than just like people that are saying, I love your channel, you're doing great things. I want to see people take what I do and actually implement that into their own lives and be able to better it. So for those of you that haven't started your YouTube journey, if you look at my first actual video, it totally sucked. They're very cringy, bad lighting, bad camera, and everything like that. I stuttered, said a lot of ums, which I still do, so I'm sorry about that. But I shared my journey doing it. I got into it a lot different than a lot of people do getting into YouTube. A lot of people feel that they need to be very successful before they can ever share their journey. They think they need to be a millionaire or make six figures by the age of 18 to be able to have a brand on Instagram, have a brand on Facebook or YouTube, or wherever those social media websites are. They feel like they need to be successful. That's not how I did it. I literally, every time I learned something new in the industry and every time I failed, I shared it on my YouTube channel. And I think a lot of people were able to resonate that way with me. And that's why, even though I don't have a big following, just under 4,000 subscribers, the people that are actually subscribed I'm able to resonate very well with, and I think they're able to trust me with the information that I give, which I'm super grateful for. But I do have to give my some respect to myself too, because I did have that goal in mind when I was trying to start my journey. So obviously I don't make a ton off of YouTube, but you guys can see here, like, monetization. That kind of leads me into my third point, like, how did I monetize it to the point where if I had a big YouTube channel, I'd be probably making the same amount in YouTube AdSense as I do in this other way. So I expanded the income sources off of it, which a lot of people are starting to do now, which I think is super smart. I released videos for 6 months, pretty much every single day, talking about everything you could kind of think of in the phone flipping industry. Everything, all the scams, all like the basics, all the advanced stuff. I released everything you need to know off of it. And then I was able to build the credibility and then start a course. So for me, getting that $8,000 per month, that's not all profit from just buying and selling phones. A lot of that is from course sales as well. And a lot of people think that's super bad or whatever, but it's an income source, right? I was smart enough to be able to build an audience, monetize that audience, and in a sense, like, only make and be able to make a lot of money off of courses, literally off of only about 3,500 subscribers, is where I push a lot of my course sales to. Obviously, I've built an email list. I have a decent sized Facebook group now. And I'm able to push in several different ways, but that just came with time. I played the long ball of things, but I documented the journey. I built credibility, and then I was able to kind of monetize that credibility by not only getting monetized on YouTube, but also selling courses, also doing one-on-one coaching and everything like that. And so if you guys are in that small YouTuber space or not even starting it, build off that personal brand. Building off my personal brand has 100% allowed me get to that $8,000 per month range, which in my eyes is decently successful for my first year of business. So like a lot of people would be like, that's nothing. Well, if it's your first year of business, don't expect to make $100,000 per month your first year of business. It needs to scale exponentially, but it might take 5, 6, 7, 8 years. So for me, that's how I think. You gotta think on that 5, 10, 15 year kind of scale kind of thing. But all it takes is for you to kind of put yourself out there. So many people don't start their personal brand, and I hate it, because they can monetize so much off of it, not only just from what they do, but then they can sell courses, sell kind of monthly subscriptions, whatever it may be. There's so much money to be made out there. And then kind of the last point I want to make for the video is I figured out how to automate the process. For me, automating what I do is a little bit more difficult, but for me, how I automated my business was I was able to learn all the scams, and then I don't really outsource work. That's not my definition of automation, because it's really impossible in my industry. But I figured out kind of the two ways. I can either go into a bigger scale of doing whatever I do, or I can get into like retail. So I don't want to talk too much specifically about my niche, but figure out from the beginning, what are the ways you can scale that business? Don't go into it not knowing how you can scale that business. Literally sit down and be like, is this something I wanna go into? Is it very profitable in the long run? And can I make a full-time income out of it consistently? And so, to be honest, the phone flipping industry isn't necessarily like a 10, 20, 30 year kind of spectrum, specifically for me and how I wanna make my money. But I thought on like the 5, 6 year kind of spectrum, and it's worked out great for me. So figure out whatever you're gonna go into to get to that $0 to $8,000 or $0 to $20,000 per month. Figure out how you're gonna get there and kind of reverse engineer it. And I guarantee you're gonna have a lot of success. And along the way, if you don't find a passion for it, get out and try something new. But if it's making you money, stay with it and then just try something on the side. So that's pretty much I have for you today in today's video. This actually is the second time I filmed it. I got to the same point last time, and literally the SIM card just got like hacked, or what, I don't know how to say it, but it's just like it went out and I lost all the footage. So I hope you guys did enjoy the video. I tried to make it a little bit shorter than the first time, just to make it a little bit more simpler, and just so you guys can take these 4 points and apply them to your own business. Again, my industry and what I learned can easily be applied to any industry you want to get into. So I hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, definitely give it a thumbs up. And if you're not part of the family yet, hit that subscription button down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.